In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create your own digital planner template using either the Keynote app, the Procreate app, or both. And watch until the end where I will show you how you can get the free page templates, so stay tuned. Hi friends, I'm Keizle, and in this channel, I help you create your own digital planner so you can develop your creativity and find clarity in life. Before designing the page templates, we should first determine the size that we are going to use, so let me show you ways on how you can do that. You are already using a page template in the Goodnotes app, and you don't know its size, or you want the template that you are going to create to be the same size as the page template here, open the notebook and go to that page. If you don't have the page yet, you can tap the page with the plus icon in the upper right corner and select the templates here. Once the page is ready, tap the share icon in the upper left and select export this page. Then select PDF. If you don't see these options here, toggle this button. I have all the options toggled on and then export. Select save to files. Then access the location where you stored the file. This is the one that I have saved. Tap on it for a few seconds and in this option, tap Get Info. Scroll down until you find the resolution. This will be the size that we are going to use, so take note of it. You can use Quick Notes by diagonally swiping your Apple Pencil from the lower right corner of your screen. If you use a digital planner already, you can also use this process. And if you still have the digital planner or digital notebook file saved in your files, you can directly access that and then tap for a few seconds and in the options, select Get Info and take note of the resolution. This is my 2022 digital planner setup, and if you are interested in watching how I created it, I will link the video in the upper right corner of the screen and in the description box below. The size of this digital planner is 1024 by 690. After taking note of that, open the Keynote app so we can create the page template. Use any theme that you want, just make sure to go to the document setup and change the slide size. I'm going to use 1024 by 690. Select all the objects so we can delete them. Here you can use the plus icon to add shapes and elements to create the page template. For the guides, you can use them or toggle them off if you don't want to use them. You can use the brush icon to customize the characteristics of the selected element, and in my case, it is this rectangle. This is the general process on how to create a digital page template using the Keynote app, and I will keep the design fairly simple just to show you how to create them. This page template can be used as a weekly base page layout and can be used with other stickers. Once the design is done, you can again access the other option, which is the three button icon in the upper right corner, and select export and choose images. For the format, I always use the PNG file format and then save the image to your photo library. If you want to add the page template as a notebook template in the Goodnotes app, go to the app and in the gear icon, tap the notebook templates. To create a new group, tap the plus icon in the upper right corner of the window. Then tap the plus icon under the group you want the template to be added, then select the template you just created. If you want to rename a notebook template, tap the edit in the upper right corner and select the template. Then rename by changing the title, then tap save. And here is how you can use the notebook template. And as you can see, because we use the same resolutions, the pages are the same. Now let me show you how you can create a digital page template in the Procreate app. First, tap the plus icon. Use this icon here and use the width and height that we have noted earlier. Then tap create. I'm just going to create a dotted grid page for this demonstration. The dotted grid brush that I am using is the one which we created a while back, and if you don't have one yet, I have linked the video here and also in the description box below. Once the page template is created, tap the wrench icon and under share, select PNG as the file format. Then save it in the photo library. You can again add this page template as a notebook template in the Goodnotes app. The process is exactly the same as the process I showed you a while ago. When using a digital notebook or a digital planner that contains hyperlinks, if you want to preserve the links, we can't really use the page template as a notebook template. Instead, we can only use it as an image. Once you have set up the size and position of the image, make sure that when using the lasso tool, the image option is toggled off to avoid accidentally repositioning your page template. Now that you know the basic process of creating a page template using the Keynote app and the Procreate app, let me show you how I made the page template for myself. I recently bought this plant, and if you are following me on Instagram, I showed you that I made a study on how to draw this flower, and using the illustration I have made, I am now going to show you how I made my own digital planner template. So here is the illustration I have made, and I just duplicated the layer multiple times and reposition and resize all of them so that they are covering the whole page. To add more dimension to the design, I duplicated each of the layer, turned on the alpha lock, and filled the layer with a dark gray color, then turned the alpha lock off. After that, I used the Gaussian blur to add like a shadow effect. This is the basic background design, and I am exporting it to the photo library so I can further design the page template using the Keynote app. Using the same presentation file as what we used a while ago, I'm creating a new slide with the design I just made. I lowered the opacity of the image first because I don't want it to overpower the actual scribbles and writings I will write on it later when I am actually using this page template. I decided to create a daily planner template for this one. I want a space for my schedule where I can time block my day. I'm not really a big fan of time blocking most of the time because I usually just rebel against it, but I still find it useful sometimes when I feel overwhelmed and I don't know what to do. So yeah, from time to time, I'm using templates like this. I want a visual separation between the background and the different elements of the template, so I added some shapes. For the other sections of the page template, I'm thinking of having a section where I can list down the top priorities which I will focus my energy on in a specific day, just to make sure that what I am working on is the most important ones. Because knowing myself, I often feel overwhelmed when there are a lot of things that I want to do, so I hope this will help me focus on the most important stuff. I also reserved a space for tasks that I can do when the most important ones are done. I actually see these tasks as my side quests, which I can do when I already finish the main quest, i.e. the priorities. But sometimes I do them when the main task I'm working on is super hard and I want an easy win. I usually choose tasks which I can do in a few minutes just to get the feeling that I accomplished something. That usually inspires me to go back on the main task again. For the other sections, one will be just an empty space where I can do anything that I want, and the other is my scribble section. Once the section is done, I'm going to export this. Since I only want the second page to be exported, modify the slide range. Then save to the photo library. Then do the process of adding the page template as the notebook template in the Goodnotes app. And congratulations if you're still watching this video. And as a thank you, you can click the link in the description box below so you can get this page template for free. Keep in mind that this is for personal use only. And if you're going to use it, take a picture and tag me. My social handles are also in the description box below. Make sure you are subscribed to the channel because in the next video, I'm going to show you how you can create your own digital planner directly in the Goodnotes app. I'm Keizle, and until next time, bye!